Many books use the PES format to talk about possible parts of a nursing diagnosis. PES stands for Problem, Etiology, and Symptoms. In this video, I am going to define each of these components, as well as show you how to add in other components that are used in 3- and 4-part nursing diagnoses. The problem should be identified using a NANDA label whenever possible. The problem is what the client needs, which, with some types of nursing diagnoses, may not be problem-focused. The problem statement needs to clearly and concisely indicate what the client's response to their health status is. Standardized language is used for many reasons that we covered in another video. By looking at the problem statement, nurses can anticipate what the client's goals may be. However, be sure to discuss these goals with the client when a care plan is created. Sometimes the NANDA label will be general and ask you to add a more specific description of the problem to this section. Remember to include qualifiers to the general diagnostic concept as appropriate. For examples, please see the book provided in the links attached to this video. Be careful when writing your problem statement that judgmental language is not used. The problem statement should be neutral to avoid offending clients or influencing treatment decisions. The problem and etiology are connected by the phrase related to, which is typically abbreviated as R/T. This phrase is always used because it does not imply a direct cause and effect relationship, which would be practically impossible to prove for most nursing diagnoses. Nursing diagnoses are worded this way to leave open the possibility that there may be factors contributing to the problem that have not yet been identified. The etiology identifies the factors that are causing the problem. For actual nursing diagnoses, the etiology identifies the main contributing factors. With potential diagnoses, risk factors are used as the etiology. This etiology should help to individualize care for your client. The etiology needs to be as specific and precise as possible. Do not write this section vaguely, hoping that the symptoms section will explain what is going on with your patient. Write your problem and etiology as specific as possible before adding the signs and symptoms to the end. Secondary to is used to make a statement more precise and clarify the etiology. Use secondary to specify a pathophysiology or disease that is contributing to the problem. Keep in mind that it is not always necessary to use the secondary to phrase. You want to keep your diagnoses as clear and concise as possible. If a client has the defining characteristics of a nursing diagnosis, but you do not know the cause or contributing factors, you can say there is an unknown etiology. Make sure you have completed your assessment and use critical thinking to be sure you're not jumping to conclusions when you're making your diagnosis. Writing unknown etiology is not a trick to get your homework done faster. If you are unsure of the etiology, you can say that a problem is possibly related to an etiology until you have collected enough data to confirm your inference. Once you have more data to confirm the etiology, you will need to go back and rewrite the nursing diagnosis. In very few cases, the etiology may also be so complex that you cannot include it in a nursing diagnosis concisely. This situation occurs when there are too many factors causing the problem to state. In these rare circumstances, the phrase complex etiology may replace the etiology. Please note that in my experience, students do not use the phrases unknown etiology or complex etiology in their assignments or on exams. Since you are just learning, professors generally keep it simple enough so that an etiology can be identified. Symptoms are then listed at the end of your diagnosis following the clause as manifested by, which is abbreviated. Even though the S in PES stands for symptoms, signs and symptoms are listed here. These signs and symptoms are very helpful for planning interventions, so they need to be made accessible, either in the nursing diagnosis or somewhere else in the patient's chart. As a student, you will most likely be asked to list your signs and symptoms at the end of your nursing diagnosis. If there are many signs and symptoms, you may be able to list subjective and objective data separately, just below the nursing diagnosis. Just check with your teacher to see how they want it done. Thank you for watching. I am continuing to work on this series to help you through the nursing process. Don't forget to subscribe to be notified when new videos are released. In the meantime, please comment below with any questions you may have about nursing diagnoses. Links to helpful resources are provided below. You may also want to check out my related videos.